Consider the following piecewise function, and they say f of t is equal to, and they tell us what it's equal to based on what t is. So if t is less than or equal to negative 10, we use this case. If t is between negative 10 and negative 2, we use this case. And if t is greater than or equal to negative 2, we use this case. And then they ask us, what is the value of f of negative 10? So t is going to be equal to negative 10, so which case do we use? So let's see, if t is less than or equal to negative 10, we use this top case right over here. And t is equal to negative 10. That's the one that we're trying to evaluate. So we want to use this case right over here. So f of negative 10 is going to be equal to negative 10. Everywhere where we see a t here, we substitute it with a negative 10. Negative 10 squared minus 5. Times, actually I don't have a denominator there, I don't know why I wrote it so high. So it's going to be negative 10 squared minus 5 times negative 10. So let's see, negative 10 squared, that's positive 100. And then negative, or subtracting 5 times negative 10, this is going to be subtracting negative 50, or you're going to add 50. So this is going to be equal to 150. F of negative 10 is 150, because we used this case up here, because t is negative 10. Let's do another one of these examples. So here we have, consider the following piecewise function, all right? What is the value of h of negative 3? See, when h is negative 3, which case do we use? We use this case if our x is between negative infinity and 0. And negative 3 is between negative infinity and 0, so we're going to use this case right over here. If it was positive 3, we would use this case. If it was positive 30, we would use this case. So we're going to use the first case again. And so we're going to, for h of negative 3, we're going to take negative 3 to the third power. So let's see, h of negative 3 is going to be negative 3 to the third power, which is negative 27. And we're done. That's h of negative 3. Because we are using this case, you could almost ignore these second two cases right over here. Let's do one more example. This one's a little bit different. Below is a graph of the step function g of x. So we can see g of x right over here. It starts when x equals negative 9, it's at 3, and then it jumps up, and then it jumps down. Match each expression with its value. So g of negative 3.0001. So negative 3.0001, so that's right over here. And g of that, we see, is equal to 3. So this is going to be equal to 3 right over here. G of 3.99999, almost 4. So let's draw a dotted line right here. It's going to be almost 4. Well, g of 3.99999 is going to be 7. We see that right over there. So that is equal to 7. G of 4.00001. So g of 4 is still 7, but as soon as we go above 4, we drop down over here. So g of 4.00001 is going to be negative 3. I want to, actually, let's focus on that a little bit more. How did I know that? Well, I know that g of 4 is 7 and not negative 3 because we have this dot is circled in up here and it's hollow down here. But as soon as we get any amount larger than 4, then the function drops down to this. So 4.0000, as many, you know, just slightly above 4, the value of our function is going to be negative 3. Now let's do g of 9. So g of 9, when x is 9, we go down here. You might be tempted to say it's negative 3, but you see at this point right over here, we have an open circle. So that means that, well, it's not, you can't say that the function is negative 3 right over there. And there's no other place where we have a filled in circle for x equals 9. So the function g actually isn't defined at x equals 9. So I'm going to put undefined right over there.